And a very good morning to all across this great country of ours. It is indeed a great day, this Taco Tuesday, the 25th of July. It's a big welcome back and round of applause for Lisa Wilkins.
Gee, I took the time, didn't I? I can't. This is me clapping right now.
Nicole Kidman of you.
Yeah.
It is. Yeah. I just need some big baubles on my hands to be able to get away with it.
The sound of one hand clapping.
It is a little bit like that. It's nice to be back. Mm. So, anyway, we'll tell the story of my complete and utter disaster of a holiday a little bit later in the show.
For sure.
Look at that. That's not a sight you see every day.
No, it is.
Golly, what a great
Does he have a license to drive that thing?
I'm not sure he's got a license to drive anything, Richard Wilkins, nor should he be this morning.
Gee whiz.
That's a very good point.
Morning, my man.
Oh, I tell
you
what.
There we go.
Prosciutto had a big night
cool
on the vanilla
wheels.
Milkshakes, I gotta tell you. Wow.
Prosciutto. Talk
to be a fly.
Those balls,
that's a lot of mascot in one little car.
Isn't it what?
Why is Dickie puffing?
Morning, gang. How we doing?
He's completely out of breath.
Come on.
Why is he getting sunglasses on?
Given I don't know.
It's still dark.
I don't know. Richard Wilkins, you are a living legend. Morning, Deb.
Hi, Carl.
How are you going, Deb?
Good, thanks.
Yeah. You got the news coming up, haven't you?
Yeah, not long.
And you've got a big cash giveaway as well, Deb.
Huge, Carl.
Yeah,
huge.
Lots of cash.
Making it rain, Deb. It's amazing. All right.
Let's get the real thing now.
And the big cat residents of a zoo in China have received special treats to beat the summer heat.
How good's Yum Cha?
Oh, yeah.
That's my favourite thing on a Saturday.
It's delicious, isn't it?
And a Sunday, and sometimes on a weekday, Wednesday.
Pretty much 7 days a week, I think.
But I'm hardcore with Yum Cha, I just want you to know.
What does that mean?
I like the chicken feet.
Oh, really?
I love chicken feet.
That's authentic.
What bit of the chicken's foot do you eat? Like, is there anything you leave behind?
It's pretty obvious.
I know, but it's just bone and some pretty unattractive wrinkly skin with a couple of hairs coming out of it. It is! I'm not kidding! Guys, it is. It really is. All right, time now for some sport.
And a feisty feline has caused chaos at a baseball game in the US when it emerged from a dugout. Everyone stood and watched while the cheeky kitten darted around the field, occasionally slowing down as it got close to players. That was until a brave groundskeeper came to the rescue. The animal wasn't too happy, though, about being removed from the field, trying to start a cat fight. Kitty bitter, Carl and Lisa.
Oh, yes.
Well, that's what happens when you try and get to third base too quickly.
Oh. Take your time.
It's very good, Carl. Well done.
Tickets on sale at Ticketek. So there you go, a little taste of entertainment, more coming up.
Fantastic. Now, you know how you're taking me to the Boxing Day test?
Mm-hmm.
I'm taking you to Alanis Morissette, late January.
I'd rather put my hand in a blender, Lisa.
No, I'm taking
you. She's already done that.
Not funny!
Sorry.
Cast a line into the lake behind us and caught a carp. Oh my goodness, their mouths are like so disgusting, Tony. That is truly foul.
Yeah. Yeah,
and
just...
I have to make one gag before I throw back from carp to carpe diem.
Oh,
it's time to seize the day, my friends.
Beautiful, yeah.
How long is it going to survive out of water? Can we ask, Natalia?
Yeah, Tony, they just want to know how long a carp can survive out of water.
Several hours, probably 3 to 4, easily.
Oh.
Probably a bit longer.
Easy. Walk in the park, you could go for a little... Oh, no. He said, I can actually put my fingers near its mouth. Is that possible?
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay,
no,
wow, there we go.
Just wouldn't. Just really wouldn't.
It's just not a nice feeling. I can't describe it. It's just really unpleasant. There you
all
go.
All right.
And
that
have
looks
a nice
fabulous,
day.
That science exhibition tomorrow morning. Good stuff, Natalia.
Yeah.
Really interesting stuff today. So how are you doing? And can we talk about what transpired?
Yeah, look, I'm okay. I'm a long way from 100%, but I'm thrilled to be back. And, look, to be honest, I'm a little bit embarrassed about it because a lot of people watching this right now are in hospital doing it much tougher than me. I will get better. either. So, but basically it wasn't the holiday that I was planning. And I also figure that, you know, for anybody who follows me on Instagram, one of the things I love doing is taking photographs.
Very
and so
having
I was...
The koala, sorry.
I'm just ignoring it. I was happily posting all of these beautiful photos from Italy. I was 24 hours into the trip. And unfortunately, we were having a problem with the water in the bathroom. Yeah. And then I'm on the slippery marble floor. We got, yeah. And this bathroom actually had a step, not unlike this one here, about as big. So I put my hand down to take it.
Yeah.
And I just knew straight away. I looked down. Basically, my arm was an S-bend.
Ow.
And so...
Quite appropriate in the toilet with an S-bend. But...
Was there a sound? Did you hear a sound?
No, I didn't hear a thing, but I looked down and I just knew straight away. And Pete, God love him, always likes to look on the bright side, and he said, just a sprain?
Yeah. Oh,
he said, it's broken.
No.
The search is on for Australia's most ordinary rig. And to tell us all about it is last year's winner, Dan the Dingo Laden. Good morning, Dan. Yes.
Hey, Carlos, how are you?
Just turn side on for us, bro.
Oh, turn around? What?
Yeah, yeah.
Side on?
Yeah. Yeah, side on.
That's better.
There he is.
There we go.
It's just magnificent.
Hello.
How much work does it take to maintain that fabulous physique, Dan?
Lisa, it's pretty hard because this day and age with the pressure of body image and all the healthy food options, you've got to really block that out. And you've just got to really keep a low heart rate and a high calorie intake, and you're just going to be ordinary like this.
I'm figuring you wouldn't be a creature of Instagram then.
Oh, no, I've got 500 followers, so they're just loving me.
Yeah, exactly.
I've just got to keep them real.
Don't go breaking my heart.
You stuff that one.
You take the weight off of me. Oh, honey, when you're in the door.
That was me.
Ooh.
Oh, this is terrible.
Oh, this is not great so far. Okay.
Ooh, nobody knows it. But when I was down, I was your clown. Nobody knows it.
A bit of guy solo.
But right from the start, I gave you my heart. Ooh, I gave you my heart.
Woo.
All right, guys, that's all right.
Take a bow.
I think the last time we did that, there was tequila involved.
Yes, there was.
A bit
very
early
good.
For that.
Anyway, I'll see you in Japan. Harajuku gyoza.
Next
yes,
stop, Tokyo.
See you soon.
Arigato.
Yes.
Yamata.
I would add some words. Sayonara. That's
sayonara.
All I know. There we
great
go.
Great stuff.
And if you really want to spoil your four-legged friend, Dr. Katrina Warren is here with the latest pet accessories. Good morning,
good morning
to you. Carl's standing in a very weird position, so... Here's the thing, whatever the weather, dogs need to be walked. Carl looks like he's got the solution.
There you go. This is an umbrella. Watch this, see? It goes down like that and then comes out like that, so your dog...
Yeah, well, the brief was find the quirkiest pet products I could.
So
I think I've done a good job.
You
love this, Carl, with the Woody family, fake sticks, OK? Really cute.
Yeah.
Available from Duke. And then these, okay, they look a little weird, but these are called the Kong Safe Stick. So there, I know.
What is that?
Would you like that?
No, I would not like that.
This is a safe stick, so it's made from safe material, so dogs can't choke on it, basically.
But wait, what do they do with it?
They throw it. You throw it.
Oh, I see. That's right. Okay. Okay. Someone wants his own.
And you've got your little bumblebee over there. So all of these little products are from Duke, but the stroller's from Petstock.
Okay. Fantastic. Thank you very
much
for that,
Katrina. And Carl, that seems to you, maybe.
A plastic stick.
Yeah, that's apparently a plastic stick.
Anyway, each to their own, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Merrick, thank you.
Yep, more than welcome. I'm happy to get out on that high.
Mate, what a lovely party.
I don't even know what that accent is.
I wasn't invited.
No, nothing.
Hey, bro, what are you doing here, bro?
Oh, I'm sitting here, bro, filling in for Lisa.
Where is Lisa, bro?
I'm not sure. She's gone somewhere,
did
bro.
Did she have a hungy?
I think she might.
She's gone with Barnaby George.
He dug in the ditch.
She forgot to dug it.
She hasn't dug the ditch.
What's the fastest way out of here, bro?
Jetpack.
Do you have one?
No.
We're back with $110,000
cash.
How much cash?
Cash. Very good. Oh, listen to that. Yes, you got it. That's a bit wrong. All right.
Big round of applause for Deb, everyone.